I am challenged by the fact that Ashkenazic Jews score on average higher on IQ tests than the neighbors, and that African Americans score on average lower. I'm Aaron Freeman, an excitable ape, with your daily dose of sciency optimism. The success of Ashkenazi Jews cannot be gainsaid. Though they are, what, 2-3% of the U.S. population, they represent 20% of the professors in the top universities, 40% of U.S. winners of the Nobel Prizes in economics and sciences, 59% of the writers, producers, or directors of the 50 top grossing Hollywood films, and half of the world chess champions, the other half being computers. Similarly, since IQ testing became ubiquitous in the U.S. in the early part of the 20th century, Negro scores have been consistently 10 to 15 points below that of our melanin-challenged neighbors. What up with that? For one thing, I'm born in the USA. Our founding document says, "We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal." Okay, Thomas Jefferson wasn't exactly woke. But the data is what it is, and we are where we are. Theories abound. Jewish intelligence has been explained by everything from Jewish genes to Jewish mothers. Low African-American IQ scores have been blamed on everything from laziness to lead-based paints. And, of course, racism. So how to think about it? One fabulous contribution to our contemplations on intelligence was made by Dr. James Flynn, a moral psychologist from the University of New Zealand. Flynn looked at IQ test scores dating back to 1930. It turns out that every 10 years, the people who make the test have to retest a sample group to recalibrate the scores to make sure that the average comes out to be 100. But every decade, they have to keep making the test harder because the test takers keep getting smarter. And in interesting ways. For example, if I ask you or any of my modern friends, what do a dog and a fox have in common? We might say they are both mammals. They're both pack animals. They both have 4 feet. We get all biological about it. But had you asked my very smart grandfather back in 1900, what do a dog and a fox have in common? He would have simply said, you use dogs to hunt foxes. An entirely smart, wholly correct answer, and entirely appropriate to the rural American world he inhabited. IQ scores have been rising for decades everywhere in the world they have been tested, with the steepest increases in IQ scores being in developing countries. And the population with the fastest rising IQ scores? Rural Kenyan girls. There's obviously much dispute about the nature of intelligence itself. For example, in Indonesia, a country of 13,000 islands, intelligence is considered the ability to navigate by sight. Ashkenazic Jews tend to score on average lower on tests of spatial intelligence, a skill which, as we become a spacefaring civilization, may turn out to have profound implications. For me, in terms of the nature of intelligence and its significance, as with so much else in science and everything in human life, it's just too soon to tell. But I will put links below to some really interesting videos, a lecture by Steven Pinker and a TED Talk by Dr. James Flynn. It may amuse you and help inform your own opinion. But I would love to know what you think. Do you trust IQ tests? How do you define intelligence? And are you challenged by the notion that there are differences in IQ scores between ethnic groups? Thank you immensely much for watching, beloved sibling. You stayed all the way to the end. You're so smart. I make new sciencey, optimistic videos every Monday through Friday. If you enjoyed this one, please drop that like, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and share with someone you know who might themselves enjoy some sciencey optimism. I am Aaron Freeman. I am an excitable ape, and I hope you have an intellectually stimulating time as you use all your IQ to science the day.